Hello! Today I'm here with a new video and I am here with a new first impression. And today, my hair is annoying. I'm going to test out two things that I have been looking forward to, and I think this maybe will be two new favorite products. The things I'm talking about is the two new products from Lina Hallberg Cosmetics. And for you who have been on my channel for a while, you know this is my absolute favorite brand. It's a Swedish indie brand and I just love it. In my will I buy it video I was talking about these two products, and now they are released here in Sweden and Norway and Finland. I think you can buy them on Kicks. It's a makeup store. For the rest of the world, you can buy it at lindahallbergcosmetics.com. Shop Lina Hallberg. I can leave the links down below if you want to buy these. So, I'm gonna test these two out today. And it's two multifunctional products. They only release multifunctional products. Or, they have only released it. So the first one is Infinity Glass, and this you can use as a primer. You can mix it with your foundation, you can make glossy eye looks and glossy lips, and this is a loose setting powder. These come in three shades: light, medium and dark, deep, dark. I don't know if it's deep or dark. I bought the light one. So I will start with the Infinity Glass and I will use this as a primer. It comes in a little tube and it's 25 milliliters and it costs 249 Swedish crowns. And both of these products are vegan. That is really good. I think all of the products are vegan except for one pencil. But I think that pencil is going to be discontinued, so the whole range will be vegan. So I will start with this, and I'm thinking about taking it on half my face first, and we can see how it looks. So it comes out like a clear, little gooey thing. And maybe we'll put up my hair. If I can find my hair clip. It's very sticky and like glue-like. So it feels a little bit strange to have it on my face, but yeah. It doesn't smell anything. And I don't mind smelly makeup, but I don't understand why you want it to smell something. Okay, now it's too dark. Too light, I mean. Maybe like this. It's very easy to put on. And it's giving a nice glowy finish to the skin. I will zoom you in and show you the side without it and the side with it. So here I have the Infinity Glass, and as you see it's pretty glowy, and here I have nothing. So it doesn't correct or anything, it's just giving the skin a glow, and I think it looks really nice. It's pretty sticky, more sticky than I usually use for primer, but yeah, it's a nice glow. Now it's on the whole face and it is sticky like hell, but hopefully it will, the foundation will look good on it. So now I'm going to put on some foundation and I am using Lumena's Natural Glow. So this is also very dewy looking. But I like my dewy looks. I don't like matte foundation at all. So yeah. This is a glowy foundation. But this primer makes it a whole lot glowier. Gives it more glow. This is not a full coverage foundation either, so I think the prime is shining through because it's not a full coverage foundation. So I don't know how it would be if it was a full coverage foundation. Okay, so this is almost like a complete wet look. I like the dewy look, but I don't like this wet look. So I'm glad I'm using the powder because I want to tone it down a little bit. But it's very, very, very glowy. And it's very, very... it's wet looking. So if you like this look, you can go like this. But I don't like it. I like it, but I don't love it. And I don't want to look... I look sweaty. Some people like that look. I don't. But this foundation is a little bit sticky when it's on. But it's not more sticky now than it used to be on its own. So the stickiness from the primer is not peeking through. Can you say that with stickiness? I don't know. But it feels good. Why is that man wiping his car from the rain? Okay. So as you can see, I am pretty glowy right now. Now I'm going to try the powder. And I'm gonna set my concealer under my eyes. And the powder is coming in a little container with a black lid. The only thing I don't like about this container, it's got not... it's open all the time. It's got no... some powders have like a lid inside, so it doesn't go anywhere. So I think this powder is going to be everywhere. So I'm going to take my concealer from Revolution. I usually use RCMA's No Color Powder. I used to love it, but now I don't anymore. I don't think it's good on my skin anymore, and I don't know why, and I'm not happy with it. Okay. I'm gonna use one of the powder puffs from Lina Hallberg as well to bake this little under eye. Is that it? How do you like my concealer mouth? The RCMA powder is white, and then you easily see where you have put the powder. I really like it. It's a little bit different because I'm used to taking an all white powder to make it a little bit brighter under my eyes. But this feels pretty good, and the powder is very, very soft. And it's sticked good to the concealer. So this far, this good. Okay, so let's put the powder on the face. And I'm going to start with this side to set this side with the powder, and we can compare the two. To set the powder, I'm going to take my favorite brush that is big as fudge. And this is Real Techniques powder brush. This is the best powder brush I have ever used. Okay. So this powder is supposed to leave a filter-like feeling or look to it. So you don't need to use the filter on your phone. It's what they have made it all about in the commercial or in the marketing about this. I like the powder right now. I don't... okay. How should I put this? I usually mix this foundation with a lighter one. Because this is a teensy bit too dark for me. But when I then use my RCMA powder, it's lightened up my skin a little bit. So I can use only this with the RCMA powder because then it's good. But now... this powder from Lina Hallberg, it's got a little bit of color to it, so it makes the foundation a little bit darker, or it doesn't lighten up. The foundation still is the same color, so it's a little bit too dark for me right now. Shoot. But it is really, really nice to the skin. I have dry skin, so a lot of powder makes me dry and makes the makeup doesn't look good. But this one, it looks amazing. It's blended into the skin perfectly. And it has a little bit of that glowiness is still there, like here on my cheekbone. It still is there, but it's not as glossy as this side. But yeah, I really like it. So now I have the powder all over my face, and I don't think you can see that my face is a little bit darker than my neck. But it's nothing that bothers me. I think I can go like this today, so I'm going to do it. It's smooth as fudge, this powder. So yeah, and it worked great to have under my eyes, so I am super satisfied at this moment. This I think is going to be a favorite. I have problems with very dry skin at some times, and right now I'm not in a good period with my skin. It's dry and the powder is not looking good at my skin at all, but this really looks good and it looks like my skin, but a little bit smoother. So I'm going to put on the rest of my makeup. I'm going to do a little bit of contour, maybe a little bit of blush and a little bit of highlighter, and I will see how they are working together with this, but I think it should be no problem at all. So I come back in a sec for you, but a little bit longer for me. So this is the finished look, and I am so happy with these two products. It feels really good on my face. It doesn't feel drying or anything, and it was super easy to put on blush and contour and highlight. So I'm gonna link these two in the description down below if you want to buy them. If you live in Sweden, Norway or Finland, you can go to Kicks and buy them. They are launching this Friday. I don't know which day this comes up. 24th of August they are launching. So check them in if you want to. And yeah, I can really recommend this for. I will put in the description box how I think they were performing the whole day. I'm going to have this on for a couple of hours so I can see if it stays on good or if it's not. So I will write it down in the description box what I think about this product. So I really hope you enjoy this video, and I will see you in the next one.